So guys, speaking of unions and stuff like that, let's talk about George R.R. Martin getting his HBO deal suspended. So there was an interesting article here from Bounding Into Comics, which kind of goes over this announcement that George R.R. Martin put up on his blog that talks about how his overall deal with HBO has been suspended due to the writer's strike, and he's actually being forced to work on his book.
Due to the writer's strike? I'm sorry, I forgot he was a writer. Interesting.
Well, he's been a screenwriter in Hollywood for a long time.
I know, I'm joking, bro. He's been
working on a lot of different Game of Thrones based HBO projects, but now that everything's shut down, he's like, oh, I'm going to work on a play, and I might get around to like my book. Now, Kyle, it's been like what?
I feel like the play's going to have a lot of penises.
Yeah, it's been like 15 years since the release of Dancing with Dragons, if I'm not mistaken. But it's been a long time. So, like, is this kind of like a blessing in disguise where, like, he got his HBO deal kind of, you know, taken away? So now he's actually got to write Wins a Winner?
I mean, it could be, but he's already set himself multiple deadlines at this point. I think it was like last June or July. He actually went out and said, if I don't, you know, publish Wins a Winter by now, you're allowed to, like, imprison me in a cell with a typewriter. That was a year ago, man. I think he's written himself into a corner. I heard something at some point, unsubstantiated, that, like, he killed off a character that he actually really needed, and now he doesn't know what to do. And that seems to fit at this point. Like, maybe he's got his expectations up really, really high and he's really, really nervous because season 8 of the show was absolute garbage and he's worried, oh my God, what if that happens to me? Or the conspiracy theory that I heard at some point, season 8 was how he was planning on ending the series, but everyone hated it. So he's like, oh, now I've got to backtrack and make something good. I like to steal, man. I like to see people from a positive perspective, but realistically speaking, I don't think he's really going to do anything. Maybe he'll work on a play, but I don't think we're getting Winds of Winter anytime soon. I hope I'm wrong on that because I loved those books, but like, fool me once, shame on me, or shame on you, rather.
Yeah, Brian, even if we do get Winds of Winter, he's still got one more book, A Dream of Spring, that he's got to complete to finish the saga. So what do you think of this news that basically, like, now that HBO, because he said that he's editing another Wild Cards book, he's working on a theatrical play version of a Game of Thrones story, and of course he's got the Winds of Winter thing, but he's also striking with the current writer's strike for Hollywood. So I mean, at this point, like, are we ever going to see another book from this guy?
No, we're not. In fact, I feel like if he's actually out there striking, then he's walking around with a giant, like, 24 pack of donuts and just loving the fact that he doesn't actually have to write anything. I mean, he's not going to do anything, bro. That poor guy is going to – think about this. The second he actually writes it, no matter how it plays out, it's going to be bad for him. Let's say everyone likes it, then it's over for him. Everyone hates it. It's over for him. If 50% of people like it, 50%, no matter what, when he finishes it, the run's over. From that perspective, he should never finish it.
I'm getting this this thing in my brain to where we're going to get like this news on CNN or something pretty soon that says George R.R. Martin has been kidnapped by a superfan and locked in a dungeon somewhere with a typewriter.
It's going to be misery.
It's going to be misery.
He can't press charges because he said it was okay to do that.
So I'm actually kind of glad because as a non-book reader, I have all the books, but I vowed to myself that since I'm kind of stupid and can't read very good, that I'm not going to read these books until I can have them all in front of me at once. And I can just like go to my grave and finally finish on my deathbed.
Vader hopes he never finishes them.
So no, for real, I have the books, but I have told myself I'm not going to bother starting to read them until they're all done. So I'll probably never read these books, but I do love the series. I can't say that the show sucks because I never read the books, you know. So I like what we got. Season 8, yeah, that was garbage. I'm not gonna lie, it was garbage. But I like the show. I can't feel the pain that the book readers have because I'm not a book reader. But
yeah, I'm a long suffering book reader, unfortunately. Yeah. But Odin, I want to throw this to you because basically, from what I understand, George R. R. Martin. So we've got House of the Dragon that he was working on. We've got A Knight of the Seven Kingdoms, which is the new spinoff that's going into production. But he was also developing like three other Game of Thrones centered shows with HBO. And now all that is kind of on pause until the writer's strike and the actor's strike and stuff like that is resolved. Ironically enough, the second season of House of the Dragon is still shooting because they're using UK actors who have a different union. So they're not striking. So that show's still moving forward. But from the economics of this as being like a tentpole of the Max original series, you know, kind of strategy, how smart is it to sideline George R. R. Martin?
There's so many different factors going on with it that I think that you could make an argument for the positive and for the negative. But I think, and honestly, the way you look at his career, and especially the last like 15 years since the last time he wrote a book, it almost seems like he has ADD. Because if you think about it, he's been working on this other book, but then every time he gets to a place, what happens? He's like, oh, I have another idea. Let me write this instead. All right. And then he like puts that out instead. And then all of a sudden he's like, wait, I got another idea. And so it honestly just feels like maybe with this, again, how much of this is being impacted by, based on how I read it, it sounded like this was more so because of the strike, because that's what he is kind of like doing. His focus is on that. So it kind of makes sense for there to be some kind of maybe suspension there. Again, I don't know how it works when your writer is a part of the union in the United States, but your show is being made in the UK, like what kind of crossover stuff you have to deal with. So that could ultimately make some sense there. But also, I think that it could also be an indication of, all right, yeah, you really need to start to get your stuff together. You need to get your act together, and you need to actually start focusing on these projects because you're just kind of just working on random things every now and then. It's just crazy.
Yeah, you know, he's got his own theater out there in New Mexico, and the Jacques Cousteau Theater or something like that, Jean Cousteau. So he does a lot of stuff in his local community.
Mm-hmm. See, when he does actually finish this book, if it ever does get released, is there going to be parties and festivals based around the release of the book? Are we going to be camping out at the in front of the bookstore and
you know, like that scene in Star Wars where Alderaan explodes and the voices of a million people suddenly being silenced? It's going to be the opposite of that. Okay?
Yeah, but what's blowing my mind is I didn't realize that there's still another book after this one that he hasn't finished yet. You guys are doomed. You book readers are doomed. You're never going to get the end of this thing. He's 80 years old, right?
He specifically stated that if he dies before it finishes, he's not allowing anyone to finish it. he's not going to allow Brandon Sanderson to come in.
Oh, man.
He's just holding everyone hostage, right?
Exactly. He's like, y'all better keep me alive.
Hey guys, if you like this podcast, don't forget to like and subscribe to the channel and comment below on your favorite video as well. That goes a long way with helping us boost our channel and get out there in front of more people. And it lets YouTube know that we're doing something right. And if you want to catch us live, we go live 2 times a week, once on Saturdays at 10 a.m. Pacific time and on Tuesdays at 1:30 p.m. Pacific time. So join us there in the chat. We will see you on the live stream. Stay salty.